Let's solve this question. This question says us that the function is changing at two points. One is at x is equal to 2 and one is at x is equal to 10. First of all, we'll take the limit at x is equal to 2. Left hand limit at x is equal to 2. For the left hand limit, x approaches to 2 negative. And the function for this is 5. As you all know that a constant function has no limit and there is no effect of limit on this constant function, the answer will be same, 5. And at x is equal to 2 also, the function is, means at f of 2 also, the function is 5. Now we'll go for the right hand limit. Limit x approaches to 2 positive, and the function for that is ax plus b. Now we'll put the value, put x is equal to 2 plus h. As x approaches to 2 plus h will approach to 0, this will become limit h approaches to 0 a into 2 plus h plus b. If h approaches to 0, this will become 0 and this will be twice of a plus b. As the function is continuous at both these points, means this, this and this, they are equal. So from here, we know that if any function is continuous, then f of a is equal to left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. So one equation we got, 2a plus b is equal to 5. We'll count it as equation number 1. Now we'll go for the second point where the function is changing, means at x is equal to 10. At x is equal to 10, for the left hand limit, the function is ax plus b, and for the right hand limit and for x is equal to 10, the function is 21, means a constant value. So we'll take f of 10. F of 10 is 21. Right hand limit at x is equal to 10 is limit x approaches to 10 plus and it is 21. So automatically the limit will not change anything for the constant term, so that will remain as it is, constant term only. Now we'll go for the left hand limit. Here it is limit x approaches to 10 negative and the function is ax plus b. We'll put x is equal to 10 minus h. As x approaches to 10 negative, h will approach to 0. So this will become limit h approaches to 0 and it will become 10 minus h plus b. As h will approach to 0, so this will become 10a plus b. And it has been told that the function is continuous. It implies the value of this is equal. Same here, f of a is equal to left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. So the second equation be 10a plus b is equal to 21. Now, in class 10th, you people have done linear equations in two variables. The same way, we'll solve these linear equations in two variables by the method of elimination. We'll change the sign, minus, minus, minus. This is cancelled. B is eliminated. It is minus 8a is equal to, we'll subtract 21 and 5. So the answer is minus 16. Minus is cancelled with minus. A is equal to 16 by 8 means A is equal to 2. We'll put the value of A in equation number 1. So that will be 2 into 2 plus B is equal to 5. 4 plus B is equal to 5. B is equal to 5 minus 4. B is equal to 1. A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 1. So they wanted us to find the values of A and B here. We have calculated the values of A and B. Now we will do exercise 5.2. There are 10 questions. I'll try to do few of the questions from this exercise today. Question is, differentiate the function with respect to x. Pehla function diya hai main, y is equal to sine and the place of the angle is x square plus 5. Isko hum kai tarike se kar sakte hain, but I will try the smaller and the easier one. First of all, we'll write differentiate with respect to x. Isko x ke with respect to differentiate karna hai because question ke andar yehi kaha gaya hai. This will become d by dx of y means dy by dx. We know that the derivative of sine of the angle is cos of the angle multiplied with derivative of the angle again. So dy by dx has come as cos of x square plus 5 multiplied. Now we'll just find out the derivative of x square plus 5. So derivative of x square is power. Niche aa gayi. Power mein se ek kam kar diya. Into derivative of x. That will be 1. Plus constant ka derivative 0. So the answer is 2x into cos of x square plus 5. This is your answer. Now, we'll do the question number 5. Bahut important concept hai iske andar. Quotient rule. U by V. First of all, we'll discuss about this rule and then we'll start with the question. Ab agar maan lijiye aapke paas aise do functions hain jo quotient ke taur pe yani numerator aur denominator ke taur pe likhe hue hain aur aap unko ek single function nahi bana pa rahe hain, jaise is case ke andar sine का एंगल डिफरेंट है, कॉस का और साइन दोनों का एंगल डिफरेंट है, तो इसको हम टेंजेंट ऑफ थीटा नहीं लिख सकते. सो इसलिए ये दोनों डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फंक्शन है और ऐसे ही ये न्यूमरेटर और डिनोमिनेटर के तौर पे रहेंगे. तो जब कभी भी इस किस्म के फंक्शन का तो फॉर्मूला आपके पास क्या है, जो भी डिनोमिनेटर है उस पूरे फंक्शन का होल स्क्वायर कर दीजिए, वो फंक्शन एज इट इज ऊपर लिख दीजिए, इनटू जो न्यूमरेटर है उस फंक्शन का डेरिवेटिव लीजिए विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स, फिर बीच में लगाइए माइनस का साइन और जो न्यूमरेटर वाला फंक्शन है वो एज इट इज इनटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ जो डिनोमिनेटर फंक्शन था अब उसका डेरिवेटिव लीजिए. सो दिस इज द फॉर्मूला, वी इनटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ यू माइनस यू इनटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ वी डिवाइडेड बाय वी स्क्वायर. सो अब इसी फॉर्मूले का यूज करते हुए विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन. You have to write down always that differentiating with respect to x. या जिस भी function के तौर पे आपको differentiate करने के लिए कहा जाए, अब इस case के अंदर आपको with respect to x कहा गया, तो हम with respect to x कर रहे हैं. So dy by dx is, अब denominator का square करना था, तो that has come as cos square cx plus d. Cos of cx plus d as it is into derivative of sine of ax plus b, and then we'll put a sine of minus sine of ax plus b as it is into derivative of cos of cx plus d. So next step, this will remain as it is, cos cx plus d. And we know that the derivative of sine of the angle is cos of the angle. Cos of the angle into derivative of the angle. Derivative of the angle minus sine theta as it is sine of the angle. And we know that derivative of the cos of the angle is minus sine of the angle. Means that has come as minus sine of cx plus d and multiply with the derivative of angle, that is cx plus d, and in the denominator it is cos square cx plus d as it is. Now one cos of the angle into cos of the another angle, so we cannot multiply both of them because their angles are different. Dono ke angle alag alag hone ki wajah se hum inhe multiply nahi kar sakte. और डेरिवेटिव ऑफ ए एक्स प्लस बी, बी तो कांस्टेंट है, कोई भी उसके पास वेरिएबल फंक्शन नहीं है, तो इसका मतलब डेरिवेटिव वो बी तो क्या हो जाएगा, जीरो, और ए एक्स का डेरिवेटिव आएगा ए। ऐसे ही यहां पर डी का डेरिवेटिव हो जाएगा जीरो और सी एक्स का डेरिवेटिव आएगा सी। सो आंसर विल बी कॉस ऑफ सी एक्स प्लस डी इंटू कॉस ऑफ ए एक्स प्लस बी इंटू ए माइनस, माइनस इंटू माइनस दैट हैज बिकम प्लस। सो साइन ऑफ ए एक्स प्लस बी इंटू साइन ऑफ सी एक्स प्लस डी इंटू सी डिवाइडेड बाय कॉस स्क्वायर सी एक्स प्लस, एंड दिस इज योर आंसर, दिस इज द सॉल्यूशन, यानी दिस इज द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस फंक्शन। नाउ विल डू क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स। दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑन प्रोडक्ट रूल ऑफ टू फंक्शंस, मींस इफ वी मल्टीप्लाई टू ऑफ द फंक्शंस व्हिच कैनॉट बी मल्टीप्लाइड एंड मेड अ सिंगल टर्म, बिकॉज अदरवाइज इट इज ऑलरेडी अ सिंगल टर्म, बट वी कैन सी दिस इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ कॉस एंड दिस इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ साइन, बट आई कैन नॉट यू नो मेक दम सिंगल फंक्शन। सो प्रोडक्ट रूल सेज डेरिवेटिव फर्स्ट फंक्शन एज इट इज इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ सेकेंड प्लस सेकेंड एज इट इज इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ फर्स्ट। वेन यू हैव टू अप्लाई दिस फर्स्ट फंक्शन सेकेंड फंक्शन एट द टाइम ऑफ द डिफरेंशिएशन, इट डजेंट मैटर विच फंक्शन आर यू टेकिंग द फर्स्ट वन एंड विच फंक्शन आर यू टेकिंग एज द सेकेंड वन। सो एनी फंक्शन यू कैन टेक एज योर फर्स्ट फंक्शन एंड एनी थिंग यू कैन टेक एज योर सेकेंड फंक्शन। सो हियर ऑल्सो विल टेक द फर्स्ट फंक्शन, वट एवर इज रिटन द फर्स्ट प्लेस विल टेक इट एज द फर्स्ट फंक्शन ओनली। सो लेट्स डिफरेंशिएट दिस बाई यूजिंग द कंसेप्ट ऑफ प्रोडक्ट रूल। सो डीवाई बाय डी एक्स फर्स्ट फंक्शन एज इट इज कॉस एक्स क्यूब इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ साइन स्क्वायर एक्स रेज टू द पावर फाइव प्लस साइन स्क्वायर एक्स रेज टू द पावर फाइव एज इट इज इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ कॉस ऑफ एक्स क्यूब। ओके सो नाउ दिस इज कॉस एक्स क्यूब एज इट इज नाउ डेरिवेटिव, बिकॉज पावर इज देयर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल टेक पावर उतार ली, पावर में से एक कम कर दिया इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ इनसाइड फंक्शन। सो हियर पावर उतार ली, पावर में से एक कम कर दिया, सो पावर इज वन इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ इनसाइड फंक्शन, इनसाइड मतलब साइन ऑफ एक्स रेज टू द पावर फाइव का डेरिवेटिव प्लस हियर इट इज साइन स्क्वायर एक्स रेज टू द पावर फाइव, और वी नो दैट डेरिवेटिव ऑफ कॉस ऑफ द एंगल इज माइनस साइन ऑफ द एंगल, माइनस साइन ऑफ द एंगल इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द एंगल। सो हियर इट इज कॉस ऑफ एक्स क्यूब इंटू ट्वाइस साइन ऑफ एक्स रेज टू द पावर फाइव, एंड वी नो दैट डेरिवेटिव ऑफ साइन ऑफ द एंगल इज कॉस ऑफ द एंगल, कॉस ऑफ द एंगल इंटू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द एंगल प्लस, so this has become plus into minus, we can write it as minus sine square x raised to the power 5 into sine x cube, and derivative of cube is power utar li, power mein se ek kam kar diya, into derivative of x, and that is 1, we know that derivative of x with respect to x is 1 only, so that has come as, we'll take out this 2 as common, 2 cos x cube into sin x raised to the power 5 into cos of x raised to the power 5, and derivative of x raised to the power 5 is 5 into power utar li, power mein se ek kam kar diya, yani 5 utar liye, 5 mein se ek kam kara, into derivative of x, that is 1, minus sin square x raised to the power 5 into sin of x cube into 3 x square. You can leave this answer here also, or if you want to take out something common from it, like you can say here it is sin square x raised to the power 5 and here it is sin x raised to the power 5. We can take out sin x raised to the power 5 as common. From here also x square can be taken out common from this, but if you won't take common, that is okay, because your answer, you have done the differentiation. Okay, Now we'll solve this question. They have asked us, you have to check the differentiability at x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2. We'll check first at x is equal to 1. Left hand derivative. Limit x approaches to 1 negative. Function is f of x minus f of a upon x minus a. So, f of x is greatest integer function x. So, that has come as limit x approaches to 1 negative. F of x means greatest integer function x minus. When we'll put the value f of a, if we'll put here 1, so the value will be 1 x minus 1. We'll put x is equal to 1 minus h as x approaches to 1 negative, h will approach to 0. So this will become limit h approaches to 0, greatest integer function 1 minus h minus 1 upon x minus 1. 1 minus h minus 1. So it will take something from 1. Ek mein se kuch agar kam karenge, so it will be something 0 point something. According to the definition of greatest integer function, this value will be 0. So limit h approaches to 0, this will become 0. This will be minus 1 and it will be minus h. Minus is cancelled with minus 1 by h. If I'll approach h to 0, 1 by h will approach to plus infinity. So your left hand derivative will be plus infinity at x approaches to 1 negative. So your left hand derivative is this. Now we'll find out the right hand derivative for this. For the right hand derivative, you just have to change right hand derivative. It will be 1 plus here. It will be 1 plus here. It will become 1 plus h. This will be 1 plus h. And here it will be changed. Because if something is added in 1, automatically it will be 1 point something. 1 point something according to the greatest integer function will come as 1. It will be plus h also. 1 minus 1 by h. And 1 minus 1 is 0. 0 by something is 0. Your left hand derivative was plus infinity. Your right hand derivative is 0. In this case, the left hand derivative is not equal to the right hand derivative. It implies the given function f of x, which is greatest function of x, is not differentiable at x is equal to 1. And second part, whether it is differentiable at x is equal to 2 also, let's check it that also. At x is equal to 2. So it will be, I'll take the right hand limit first. It will be 2 plus, it will become 2 plus h. If I'll put 2 here, this will become 2. This will become 2. This will be 2 plus h. And now it will be all changed here. So it will become limit h approaches to 0. This will become 2 plus h minus 2. 2 plus h minus 2. This 2 is cancelled with this 2. 2 plus h means something is added in 2. So the value will be 2 point something. According to the definition of greatest integer function, this value will come as 2. So that will be 2 minus 2 by h. That will be 0. Means your right hand derivative at x is equal to 2 for this function will be 0. Now let's take the left hand derivative. We just have to change a bit. Left hand derivative. This will become 2 negative. This will become 2 minus h. This will be 2 negative. H will approach to 0. All these values will be as it is up to this place. This will remain same and it will be changed. Now let's see what change comes here. It will be 2 plus, sorry, not, it is 2 minus h minus 2 upon 2 minus h minus 2. It is cancelled. 2 minus something will be 1.9 or 1.8. So according to the definition of greatest integer function, this value will be 1. 1 minus 2 upon minus h, limit h approaches to 0. That will be minus 1 by minus h. When h will approach to 0, this will approach to plus infinity. Left hand derivative is plus infinity, right hand derivative is 0. It implies left hand derivative is not equal to the right hand derivative. It means this function is also not differentiable at x is equal to 2. Here we are complete with exercise 5.2 of NCERT. In the next video, we'll do the next exercise.